Hello, my friends, and welcome to Tom's Tinkering and Adventures. Well, I always have something going on around here. I was just thinking about it, like, how do I have something every day? But, you know what? I just like to fix things. I'd rather fix what I have than throw it out and buy another one, even if it's something not so expensive, you know? I worked on my TV remote yesterday. You can buy a universal remote for $5 or $10, but and it took me a couple minutes to fix it, and that's another $5 or $10 I didn't have to spend. Well, after I got that done, my wife drug out something else that needed fixed, and it's just something that I couldn't even believe that she has. How many of you all remember cassette players? She's got a cassette player here, and the play button is all the way broken into here. Cassette player, for real. Well, Mrs. Tom's Tinkering and Adventures, my lovely trophy wife, she's a teacher. So if that cassette player tells you anything about the state of funding for our teachers these days, well, there you have it. This is books on cassette that she has. I guess she has a lot of them. So this cassette player is actually pretty useful in her class. What I really should probably do is get these things converted over to maybe a CD. I mean, come on, CDs even today? But that's what we're dealing with. So today, we're gonna take this thing apart, see if we can't fix this play button on here, because I don't even know where the heck you can buy a cassette player anymore. I suppose you can, but we'll fix it, and then we're gonna start working on upgrading this technology, because this just seems a little bit pathetic to me, but enjoy working on a cassette player today with me. If you see me work on some things like this before, I've said it, you gotta keep your eye open for hidden screws. I see some obvious ones here to take this lovely piece of engineering apart. But there are hidden fasteners every time you work on something. So just keep an eye out for the obvious ones and then move on to starting to try to take it apart. And then if it doesn't seem like it's coming apart, you know, you don't want to start forcing it immediately. I have a container here to put the screws in. I'll put this down. The screws don't just fall out. We can drop them out that way. I don't see any obvious screws on this side. This one is way in here. Let me grab a smaller screwdriver real quick. And I have no idea why that play button is dropped all the way in there like that, but I have some ideas. We'll have to take it apart to find out. Hopefully we can easily access it. When you're taking things apart, one thing to really pay attention to is fastener size. You see the size of the screw that I took out from this. The size of the one I took out on the bottom. So if you just start taking stuff apart and you're not paying attention, well, you'll be concerned when you're putting it back together. Now you can see it's already coming apart a little bit here, so let's hope for the best. Let's see. We're gonna have to open that, it looks like. Maybe, I don't know. And we got something going on. Lots of electrical doodads in here. Well, look at that. The play button's already back up here. I guess some problems. Oh, problem's not solved. Darn it. I was so happy just for a second there. right, now we're gonna have to figure out how to get into the meat and potatoes of this thing. Meat and potatoes. I am hungry. So I looked at this thing a little bit, and this volume knob has got to come off, which I have already pried out of there once. And then right inside of here, you can see it, there's a little screw. I've already started to take it out. In fact, I think I've got it all the way out already. And I think that all this stuff on the top will kind of come out. And I lost a something. Oh, the eject button. Put that in there. And let's get a good look inside of here. I'm turning you upside down. All right, here's the play button, and you can see, it looks like it just, it's completely broken off of there. So in order for that to stay on there, I'm gonna have to come up with some sort of a solution. It looks like that maybe it's either got a piece on the back that's broken. Let's take it out again. And it looks like it's been put on there with some sort of adhesive. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to get this thing cleaned up a little bit. I'll use some alcohol. And I'll put some super glue on this. We'll clean this with alcohol. We'll super glue that on there. And then maybe I'll put a small zip tie around it as well to hold it. I'll have to see. Let's see if we can operate this thing. Yeah, it's going to be problematic, that's for sure. But let's see what we can come up with. Let's see if we can get in here. I'll show you what I'm kind of thinking here. So this piece, if you look at it, you can tell it's supposed to be, supposed to have another piece around the outside, so it goes over this little tab here, but it's broken. Now I could glue this on here. Maybe it would stay, maybe it wouldn't. I don't know how well you can see this, but there's a there's a hole in this right here. I've cleaned it out with this pick. It had a little bit of adhesive goo or something in it. And on this, you can see right there, there's kind of a circle where this thing was molded. I'm wondering if I was to drill that with a very tiny drill bit, if I could feed a piece of wire through there to wire this on here. So there's a couple of things I was thinking about doing. So this whole thing ain't gonna collapse on me here. I'm just trying to hold it up so we can see what's going on. There we go. A couple things I'm thinking. Feed this back in here. So I could drill that hole through there and then glue it and put the wire around it to hold it this way, but from a couple of test attempts at pushing this thing, when I push down, it pushes right past that broken part, and I think it's just going to destroy that whole plastic. But if I put it on the back side here like this and was able to feed wire through there, then it's kind of pushing on the back of this. I think even if I just did this and wired it, not even putting any adhesive on it, it would work. There we go, stop. So I'm thinking that that's the route I'm gonna go. I really wish that I could feed this thing in completely backwards this way, but I can't get it to go into here this way. It's just too much of an angle. So you can see how this thing is built. So if I put it in that way, this is going to be way too far back. So I think I'm going to hit this thing with a tiny little drill bit. And then I'm going to put it in.
I'm going to feed a little piece of wire through there. Maybe I can get it through there twice. And then also I'm going to glue it on there. So let me take this over, drill it real quick. We'll bring it back and see how it looks. Got a hole drilled through it right there. We'll get it installed and I'll try to feed some wire through there and just see how that works. I've got this twenty thousandths safety wire. So we'll see if that'll work. If I can get that through there twice, that would be ideal. Looks like it'll fit. So it's gonna be just a little pain in the butt getting it in there though. Hopefully you can see that. I fed it through, down, around, and back through and around at the other side. So it's through there twice. I got it wrapped around there. So now I'm gonna twist these wires, twist the wires. And then I'm probably gonna put some super glue on this as well, but I'm thinking, even with just the way it is, that that's gonna work pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and twist these, cut that down a little bit. We'll add some super glue and put it back together and give her a shot. We got our wires twisted around there pretty good. My all-time favorite, super glue. This is the stuff legends are made of right here, super glue. I love having this stuff around. You can fix all kinds of goodies with it. The problem is it's pretty easy to go overboard on the super glue. So you just got to be careful, especially on moving items like this. This switch moves down, so if you get too crazy and it drips down into here, then the whole switch won't even move anymore. And it's always nice to get some on your skin as well. Another use for these pieces of wire like this is to clean out the end of the super glue, because if you don't use it after you open it, it'll get the nozzle of it will get clogged up, and usually it's still good inside of the container here. But I go through quite a bit of it. I always have a couple around. I always feel bad if my super glue supply gets low. It's a tinkering and adventuring staple. Having this, you can do quite a few things. So let's let that set up and we will put this thing back together. Putting things back together is always a lot harder than taking them apart. I've always contended that I could take anything apart for the most part. Some things I don't want to take apart, but I can take almost anything apart, but getting it back together, well, that's a whole nother ball game. And this little screw in here is a real pain in the butt. There's not a lot of room. You can't even see what I'm doing in here anyway. But that basically holds this whole top assembly into the front assembly. And while we were messing with this, I noticed that this is the antenna wire. It came off from the antenna on the back here. But I imagine this thing will work without it, and I know for a fact that my wife does not use this thing to listen to the radio. I use it to listen to the cassettes. This other screw tightened up. And if for some reason it doesn't work without this antenna wire hooked up, well then I guess we'll take it back apart and figure it out. But in the meantime, I'll just put that right back in here somewhere. Hopefully it doesn't cause any problems. Who knows? kind of looks like it's back in one piece, kind of, almost. All right, I'll get, oh yeah, look at that. There's that antenna wire. Let me move that. I'll get these screws in here and we'll give her a test, see if it works. I decided that while I was putting this thing together, I might as well at least put an effort at making this antenna work. So I just use this crimp connector and my crimp pliers and put this on here. And I'll feed this behind where this antenna screws in. There's a screw on the back of here. You can see it right there. So I'll put this behind here, between here and the screw. And then at least it'll make some contact. So while I have it apart, it's only take another minute to make this work. So we'll hook that up and make sure everything works on this thing. All right, we got her back together. Let's put the money where your mouth is here. Oh, we got noise coming out of it.
The Ravens right now.
Oh, football game's on. There we go. What better to come out of a cassette deck than 1980s music from Steve Miller. Let's go to the tape side now, though, here. All right, cassette. It's moving. Maybe it's at the end. Let's flip. Yeah, look at that. You have to turn these over for you youngsters, unless you were one of them ballers who had the auto reverse. I don't hear anything coming out of it. Let's look inside of here and see if the well, the motor's turning. It appears that it works. I don't know what's going on with these cassettes. What do we got here? Ooh, look at that. This is a good one. The Train to Timbuktu. Well, the button is working. Yeah. Nobody calls me the Space Cowboy. Uh-oh. We're on double time there for some reason. Let's try it again.
By Margaret Wise Brown. Illustrated by Art Seiden.
Well, maybe they should call me the Space Cowboy. Because I got a cassette player working today, so not too bad for a Sunday. Thank you very much for watching. Get out there and find your adventure. Adios.